is in this area, and it's taking the topsoil or the silt, the fine particles that are up there, and it's washing it down into the Gulf of Mexico. Some of you that are familiar with delta areas, you can actually see that if you go on, you know, Google satellite or something of that order. But part of the reason that we do restoration in this area is to mitigate some of the erosion from happening near the water, to slow down some of the surges that might come up here. We've had tides that have come up into the area where you are sitting. So, you know, depending upon the type of weather systems that we have, it can get quite deep. But most importantly, it's for habitat out here. And over a period of, what, 50, 60 years, Mark, we've had a widening and shallowing of our channel out here. A lot of underground pumping of water came about when people moved to this area, and when the ground, which our ground is a Verlin 15 shrink swell clay, only found in 5 places in the world, but it's a clay soil. So if the supporting structure underneath the water is not there anymore, you're not getting as much drainage through this type of clay. It sinks down, hence we have subsidence. On top of that, you've got all this silt that's flowing in every time we have a weather system, rains, and that's going to produce a really sticky, muddy mud almost that's on top of this out here. You'll feel that when we go out in the water. It's a little bit sticky, and it's right on top of that that clay. Clay, since it's now a little bit shallower and it's, you know, subsided a little bit, also provides a nutrient-rich area. And we get tidal marsh. This is a tidal marsh, so we've got tides that come in, what, 2 feet approximately, changing every day out here. And they're bringing in water that's coming in from the Clear Lake, from the Gulf area. What kind of water is that bringing in?
Polluted.
Fresh. Some polluted, yeah.
Fresh water.
Okay. If you think about going down to the beach, what kind of water do you find at the beach?
Salt water.
Salt water, okay. And then if you've got the rain and the weather system's coming in, they're bringing what?
Fresh water.
Fresh water.
You'll get brackish water.
It's a brackish water system. You get all the points. Yes, sir. Okay. Mixture of fresh and brackish water, fresh and salt water is giving you a brackish system. And we're very fortunate in this estuary out here to have this lovely mix, because a lot of different species are dependent upon a certain type of salinity, a certain amount of nutrients. And I'm sure you did some testing over here with water quality. I'd be curious to hear what you got for results.
I got a 28 degrees Celsius salinity of 6 to 7, kind of like 6.5.
Yeah.
That's what I got.
pH?
9.0.
Okay.
Less than 0.2 chlorine level.
Okay.
Did you pull the plankton net?
Yes.
And did you find plankton?
Yes, we did. We found... we did find some, what appeared to be some protozoan, so there were some ciliates, looked like what appeared to be ciliates.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And maybe flagellates, I'm not really sure, it was hard to tell. But there were some little guys, microscopic guys running around in there. They
so
were moving around pretty
that
fast.
Is in large part why the bayou water is green. You look across it, that's kind of its characteristic color. And I'm glad you had a chance to see those, because many of the fish species we're about to catch, that's what they eat, are those tiny single-celled plants. And we'll talk more about that once we actually start catching a few.
And I'm curious, you know, you said your pH was 9?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. A good growing range, something that's similar to what we have in our mouth, would be like 6 to 8. So it's similar for the animals that are out here to grow in that ideal climate. So we've got, we'll see what happens, you know, with our temperature out here and with our salinity. It's not very salty right now. During times when we've had drought, we've had a very high salinity, and that's because you've got evaporation, and then you can look at the animals that you are pulling in and determine, you know, oh, is this a saltwater animal or is this a freshwater animal? Okay.
We're going to a moon, is that right, roughly?
Man. That's going to be fast.
Yeah. You have to ask Patty.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's right.
Was it 30 minutes?